Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.6 Developer Beta 3. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers if you're not seeing it already, and it came in at about 200 megabytes or so. You'll see 206.5 megabytes. This is just a screenshot I took off one of these phones before installing it. So it's about 200 megabytes if you're coming from iOS 13.6 Beta 2. Now if you're on iOS 14 and you want to go back to that, well, you really need to use a computer in order to do that. You won't easily be able to go back to iOS 13 without a computer. Now, why is Apple still working on iOS 13? Well, for those of you that are not familiar with how it normally works every year, Apple continues to work on iOS 13 or the previous version until they release the new version later in the fall, around late September or maybe even October this year. So just keep in mind that it's completely normal for them to continue to work on iOS 13, even though they've announced iOS 14. Now, Apple also released iPadOS 13.6 Beta 3, macOS 10.15.6 betas, watchOS 6.2.8 beta, tvOS 13.4.8 Beta 3. They're all released now if you want to try them out if you're a developer. Now, let's take a look at the build number and see if we can find anything new. You'll see the build number is 17G5059C, and the C on the end makes me think we're going to have another beta before this is released to the public. So normally it will have an A on the end when we get closer to releasing it to the public. And so this particular update does not have any modem updates, and in fact the notes really don't say anything about this particular update. So we do know that right now it's got a few features that we've talked about before, and Apple's car key and that standard is coming to BMWs very soon. In fact, tomorrow is when they're supposed to start manufacturing, at least, and those cars will start to become available, the first cars that support Apple car key that allow you to use your phone through a car key to unlock it. So you can walk up next to it as though you had a key fob in your pocket, and you can unlock and start the car. Now, that should be available, although there's no way to actually add one right now. I believe you're going to go into your wallet to do that. And then when you go to add a card, you'll actually just scan whatever the barcode is, and you'll be able to add that card. However, I haven't seen one in person, but it will work with BMWs coming very soon. Now, there's other features that were in this that I showed in previous betas, but there's nothing really new in this particular one. You can see under software updates, you can actually customize the automatic updates and have it download automatically or install iOS updates. So you can just turn that off, have it download but not install it by itself, or have it install it by itself. So that's one of the updates if you forgot about that, since iOS 14 has a bunch of new features. Also, there's a couple features to Apple News, for example. So if you're using News, I don't really use News, but if you're using Apple News and you have Apple News Plus, you'll see Apple News Plus, you can start reading. It's $9.99 a month. So under News Plus, you'll be able to have it read these articles to you if they're participating in that. Also, there's some updates to health as well, where you can add symptoms. So under health, you'll see here, we'll go to browse, and now you can add symptoms of how you're feeling. So you can add any one of these, and that's really all that's in this particular update. So when this comes out to the public, you'll have all of these updates. However, it's not available now. Of course, obviously it's to beta testers, and it looks like we're going to have another beta before the final one comes out. Now, Apple could implement a few more changes, some background bug fixes, but they haven't really talked about anything. But that doesn't mean they're not fixing things in general. So it seems like it should be okay. It's been running fine the past hour or two that I've been using it since it's installed, and it's working well on the other devices. I'll talk about that in just a moment. Now, as far as battery life, well, honestly, I've been using iOS 14 most of the time, and the battery life is decent on that. So on iOS 14, if you haven't seen that, it's a nice change. I have update videos about that. But battery life, I actually reached out to people that follow me, friends and other people, and I actually got a screenshot from them to see what kind of battery life they were getting with iOS 13.6 Beta 2, because it takes a few days to know how your battery will be over time. You can't tell by the way it's decreasing. You can only tell by a full cycle or a few cycles. So you'll see I haven't used this phone that much, but let's take a look at, you'll see battery health should be 100% because I haven't used this phone in a while. We'll go to photos where they took a screenshot for me of their actual usage, and they are using a battery case on an iPhone 11 Pro Max. So that will give them amazing battery life, but you'll see 4 hours and 47 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 26 minutes of screen off time, and they've only used a quarter of their battery. Now, if you extrapolate that out as though they were using their battery over time, 15 to 20 hours of screen on time seems to be unbelievably high, but that's pretty good for normal usage. That's not plugging it in, that's using a battery case. And if you're not using a battery case, expect 10 to 12 hours of screen on time with the betas right now. They're doing pretty well, and it was doing fine before I had iOS 14 on my phone. So expect that. Now, performance is quite good. I have one of the older phones here, the iPhone 6S Plus. So you can see here, it's got the S on it, and performance is quite good. And I did run a Geekbench on these. We'll take a look at in a moment. That's the first time I've opened music, so it will take a moment to load. And you'll see scrolling's nice and fast. If we go into multitasking here or the app switcher, it's nice and fast. Everything is nice and smooth. And I would expect this to be a really solid update. Of course, we're toward the end of life of iOS 13. So of course I would expect it to be good. Although it's taken them almost a year to get it to this point. I think iOS 14 is going to be much better though. Now on iPadOS, expect similar performance, and this is an iPad Air 2, so it's the oldest supported iPad, or one of them. And again, scrolling, opening and closing apps, things are pretty smooth given its age, and expect performance to be pretty decent in general. So I wouldn't expect anything to go down. I would expect it to be the same or better. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores that I got on the iPhone 11 that I have here, as well as the 6S Plus and the iPad Air 2. So I'm using Geekbench 5, the latest version. Now keep in mind, I run these tests right after I install the beta. So these numbers usually go up a little bit, but you'll see I scored 1,326 for single core, 2,653 for multi-core. That seems a little bit low, but again, I didn't run it a second time. And you can see here's some similar comparisons. So I would expect this to be in the 3,000s if I ran it again. So let me run it again quickly, see if I can get some better benchmarks. Now, after running it a second time, you'll see I have much better scores, with 1,329 for single core, 3,214 for multi-core. So that's more what I would expect from this device. Now let's take a look at all three of them so you can compare what I have versus what you have. Now on the left, I have the iPad Air 2. In the middle, I have the iPhone 6S Plus. And on the right, I have the iPhone 11. This should give you a general idea of what your scores should be. And if they're anywhere in this vicinity, expect your phone to perform basically the same as I'm showing here or better. Now iOS 13.6 Beta 4 may be out in a week or so on the 7th. If Apple continues to do weekly updates, although it could possibly come out to the public as well, but it's really hard to say at this point. And then also I would expect iOS 14 beta 2 at that point, maybe a public release, or maybe they'll wait till beta 3 for that. So expect beta 2 of iOS 14 next week, or they could push it back a little bit further, but hopefully we'll see beta 2 of iOS 14 at that point. So that's it for iOS 13.6 beta 3. Let me know if you've found any new features or anything I haven't mentioned in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.